Okay, we're here at Formby Golf Club near Liverpool, looking at something really, really special today. We've got Ping's new Anser range for 2012. We've got Marty Jertsen, Senior Design Engineer at Ping, to tell us all about them. We have here the brand new Ping Anser iron. If you know your Ping irons, you'll know that the previous Anser was the first Ping forged iron in a good number of years, certainly since the 1960s, and they went down very well. Marty, tell us a little bit more about these updated ones.
Yeah, well, we're really excited about the latest Anser irons because we've been able to learn a lot from the current Anser irons, which perform fantastic. But what we've been able to do is kind of utilize some finite element analysis in our design techniques to make the face a little bit thinner.
Okay.
Now, on this product, we still have a ton of face support, so our CTP cavity right in the middle, and then we have a support bar that connects from the back flange all the way to the middle of the face.
Mm-hmm.
What we're trying to effectively do is create the feel and stabilization and distance control of a muscle back,
yeah,
but still put a lot of cavity to the iron, so you get plenty of forgiveness to it as well.
Okay,
so that's kind of what we've been able to do, and at the same time, so by making the face a little bit thinner, we've been able to utilize more mass here in the tungsten weight that makes up the sole and the back flange.
Uh-huh.
So that helps pull the center of gravity further away from the face to send the ball higher up in the air.
Okay.
So you combine that with a blended set design. So the three iron and the long irons have a little wider sole to them,
mm-hmm.
a little bit wider sole. They have a little more offset. They're a little longer from heel to toe. And then as we progress down into the shorter irons, they get to the soles get progressively narrower.
Yep.
The blade length gets a little shorter, and they get progressively a little bit less offset. So what you end up with is something, you know, that I think especially a lot of the better players want, which is long irons that go higher and short irons that flight it lower.
Okay.
And so this wedge will blend right into our Anser wedges, which kind of have the hourglass shape weighting to them.
Yeah.
Those send the ball out real low with a lot of spin, and so I think that's what golfers are going to see with the new Anser iron as they progress into their wedges.
Okay, and obviously our viewers will know the Ping range quite well with the S56 iron to G20 irons. Again, I'm presuming these are going to sit somewhere in the middle of that set, maybe near the I-20s and between I-20s and S56?
Yeah, you're exactly right. So they, in terms of the blade length, they're pretty close to where I-20s are, but
okay.
They have a little less offset to them, a little cleaner shape to them that I think the Ping traditionalist is still really going to love the look of them, but I think those who typically have not played Ping irons are really going to take a liking to how these sit at address. They have a real beautiful shape to them.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're right. In terms of offset, they live between the I-20 and the S56.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of size and forgiveness, they live closer to I-20.
Okay. And are we expecting to see any of the tour guys with these in their bags soon?
I think so. I think you're going to see a lot of penetration in the market with our tour guys with these.
Yeah.
We're gonna release them to them here shortly and have them take a look at them. Our I-20 iron and our S56 are doing awfully good out there,
yeah.
But we have had some requests from our tour guys for the I-20 with a slightly less offset, so this is going to really fit the sweet spot for those guys.
Okay, well, there you go. If you're a fan of Ping irons, or even if you're not, this might be a convert to you. We certainly recommend getting out, having a look at these when they hit the shops. We're really looking forward to hitting them and testing them later on in the year.